Yeah, I think it's not something you can plan for. Obviously, we built the schedule a few years ago, and all of a sudden, the dome roof collapses in December, and we find out around January 1 that we're not going to be able to play there. That was a big challenge, just to try to come up with some sort of schedule. We were very, very fortunate that the Minnesota Twins were one of the first calls I got from the Paulette family and the president there, Dave St. Peter. And I don't think they even looked at the schedule, and they offered, hey, if we can help you guys in any way, let us know. Our facility on campus is basically condemned, it's in bad shape, and we're trying to raise money to build a new one, utilizing the Metrodome over the last few years. So we really didn't know what we were going to do, as it turned out. And probably as unlucky as we were lucky the Twins were on the road and we were at home in the Big Ten. And so we were fortunate that they were able to reach out. I'm not sure what we'd have done if we didn't have that facility, to be honest with you. We tried to rebuild the schedule. I think we played the third fewest games in America. Of the 300 Division I schools, so that was a challenge. We went stretches sometimes 10 or 11 days without playing. I think we only had four midweek games in the course of the year, so it was challenging, no question about it. The only normal part of our season was abnormal. And we're used to playing on the road. We've been on the road, I think, in March. We were in the Central time zone only 11 days, the whole month of March, and it's been a challenge for the kids. I don't think we've ever got into a consistent routine to practice or play. I think it's hurt our development some, and I think in a lot of ways we're fortunate to be here. I didn't have any expectations for our team once it happened because I had no idea how they were going to come through and handle it. And so we're fortunate to be here, and maybe we can put together a solid week of baseball here and be a factor, but we're looking forward to the challenge. We've had lots of challenges. The last thing I'll say, I compliment our kids. They've shown some toughness all year. They never complained about it. You know, went to California, we missed one whole weekend at Santa Clara. It rained for 3 days, never took the tarp off. So if you go places where you think you're going to play and you don't get a chance to play, that's what I said from the beginning. The hard part was going to be, you can come up with some sort of schedule, you don't know what's going to happen after that. We did have some challenges in weather-wise in other places we went as well. So it was unfortunate, but the kids have shown some toughness. They haven't complained. They've showed up and they've been able to practice and play. And I think in our league, only one weekend we hit on the field 3 days in a row because the Target Field Twins didn't allow it. And because of the weather, we, like most of us, it was a challenge just to get on the field and get some work done. In our case, we didn't have a lot of that this year. I think at one point we only hit on the field 10 times this year. So I don't think we're much past 15 for the course of the year. So it's been a challenge, but there's nothing you can do about that. We've got to do the best we can. And like I said, we're looking forward to the